Hi dear student, after learning the halogens, halogens, definitions, meaning and classifications, we are going to name the compounds. How we are naming the compounds? That nominals are also very important. While we are isolations or identify any new compound, we are going for the naming up any new compounds. First, we are naming the compounds. That is also called as nomenclature. Nomenclature means systematic naming. A systematic naming of an organic compound is called as what a nomenclature of an halogens and halorenes. So we already learned the nomenclature very well in the first few section. First few issue. There are some rules and regulations. There are 10 rules are there while naming any organic compound. That one we have to just recall with taking some of the following example. Okay, the nomenclature, any of the organic compound we are naming, we are simply naming of any organic compound by just common name, and one more name is called as what a IUPAC name. IUPAC name. These common names are comes from the where they are available, their origin, that origins and everything depends upon this common name. But this IUPAC name is, we are going for the some rules and regulation. From that rules we are following and giving the name systematically, that is called as what a IUPAC naming. Therefore, now we have to go for the naming of a compound. Therefore, when any of the compound is one organic compound is there, means that having two type of naming. One is common naming and one more is from the IUPAC naming. Okay. And also in a common naming we are using ISO. Before that N, ISO, next one is NEO, and next one secondary, next one is tertiary. These prefixes we are using while naming the organic compound. They are very confusing using the ISO, NEO and N. This secondary, tertiary. But you could highlight mark is in the Halakistabatin. Yahoo secondary ISO new hang use Madabuko and Sadi. Okay. Then hang now. And also, bar benzene ring it under benzene. If bar benzene is under no common eye, the common name in the use Marte, arthro, meta, para, and Sadi, for his use Martino. Prabixan arthro. Para meta use marte. Idhu na hang use marte ono. Dono na example thoro na kista padte. Okay. First, we are going for the naming of an organic compound. The naming of an organic compound is here. I will go with the simplest examples also. First one. This CH3Cl. CH3Cl. What is the name of this compound? This name is chloromethane. This is what a common naming. Well, IUPAC, this is what a common naming. Well, IUPAC naming is methyl chloride. Therefore, this is what common name is chloromethane, and the IUPAC name is methyl chloride. Like this, the naming will be. Therefore, next we have to take some examples and we have to understand the concept. Therefore, that's important. CH3, next one is CH2, BR, next one is CH2, CL. Next we are going for the CH3, CL. And CL, these are the four organic compounds. How we are naming these compounds, that's important. First you go for this, the common naming. You go for first common naming. This is what secondary. The carbon atom attached to the two alkyl groups, they are called as what a secondary. Understood this one? A secondary bromo methane ethane propane. Secondary bromo propane. secondary bromopropane. While going for the IUPAC naming, select the largest chain numbering 1, 2. Therefore, 2-bromo-2-bromo-2-bromopropane. Bromopropane. And also, you see here, they are using secondary. Whenever there will be secondary carbon is there, we have to use the suffix card as iso. That's very important. Therefore, there are so many students are confusing. Where there will be secondary carbon, you have to use the iso word. That's important. Okay, next one is this one. Primary carbon. The carbon atom attached to the 2-methyl group. Primary carbon attached to the only one carbon chain. Therefore, it is called as what? Primary chloromethane ethane propylene. Primary chloropropane, and the name of this one is 1-chloropropane. This is what while naming the organic compound. Next, we take this one. These both are same. Here chloro and here only bromo. Therefore, it is primary bromopropane. Next one is okay, 1-bromo-1-bromopropane. You see here confusion. Don't go for the confusion. Where there will be primary carbon is there, we have to use the normal. Therefore, primary means we have to use normal N-chloropropane. This confusion will be going to work. Here secondary carbon means you have to use iso. If there will be primary carbon, use the N instead of primary. Otherwise, this is what just confusion you are bringing. Confusion hobeko. Hang under primary carbon to N normal chain. N chloropropane. Here also say if it is primary, you have to use N bromopropane. Also this IUPAC name is 1-bromopropane. And this one. This one is very important. This carbon is tertiary. This carbon attached to the near neighboring 3 carbon. Therefore, you are using the word tertiary. Tertiary chloro methane ethane propane butane. The tertiary chloro butane are also called as select the longest chain. This one is select the longest chain. 1-chloro. This is what the select longest chain is, this one. Not this one. 2-chloro-2-methyl propane. You see here, student, don't confuse this IUPAC naming. Select the longest chain. Numbering 1, 2, 3. Therefore, second question, chlorine as well as methyl is there. 2-chloro-2-methyl propane. And here, you have to use secondary idra iso use madartidda, primary idra n use madartidda. If tertiary idra, you have to use tertiary. Tertiary use madre. Okay, next, this is what while naming of organic compound. You have to take this. There are so many examples in your books. While naming of any organic compound. This is what the first piece, the basic fundamental what you learn. Okay? So many compounds we are naming. Go for this. So many examples. You see here, this compound, well, naming organic compound, you see here, just what I explained in the classification of organic compound, carbon-carbon double bond followed by the carbon-carbon single bond attached to the any halogen atom, chlorine. Here also same, carbon-carbon double bond followed by the carbon-carbon single bond attached to the one of the halogen. How we are naming this one? The carbon-carbon double bond and carbon-carbon single bond, this chain is called as what? Allylic. Allylic and carbocline. Where what is allylic? Carbon carbon double bond followed by the carbon carbon single bond compound. They are called as allylic. While naming this compound, where how you are naming this compound. That is very important. Chloroalyl compounds. Next one, this one. Bromine is there. Bromoalyl. Next one. We are going for this. Sometimes we are naming, how we are naming, you know, this one. Allyl chloride. Otherwise, this is what? Allyl bromide. Therefore, this is what I am naming. This is what a common naming. In IPSC naming, how you are naming? One person, next two person, third person. Therefore, we are naming one chloropropene. This is what propene. Why we are using ENE? This is carbon-carbon double bond. And similarly, next this one is one bromopropene. This is what I am naming compounds IUPAC as well as a common naming. This is allyl chloride or allyl bromide. This one bromo. Propene. This is what a naming of an organic compound. Similarly, we are going for the naming of some other compounds also. You take this. How to name this compound? CH2 double bond CH bond F. CH2 double bond CH2 ಇತ್ತಂದ್ರೆ ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ನೀವೇನಂತ ಕರಿಬೇಕು? ವಿನೈಲ್. ದೇರ್ಫೋರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಅ ಫ್ಲೋರೋ ವಿನೈಲ್ ಫ್ಲೋರೈಡ್. ದಿಸ್ ನೇಮ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಅ ವಿನೈಲ್ ಫ್ಲೋರೈಡ್. ದೆನ್ ಮೋರ್ ನೇಮಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕಾಮನ್ ನೇಮಿಂಗ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಡಬಲ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಫಾಲೋಡ್ ಬೈ ದಿ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅಯೋಡಿನ್. ದೇರ್ಫೋರ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನೀವೇನು ಯೂಸ್ ನೋಡ್ರಿ, ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಡಬಲ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಇತ್ತಂದ್ರೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಏನಂತ ಕರಿ ನೀವು? ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ವಿನೈಲ್ ಅಂತ ಕರೀರಿ. ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಅಯೋಡಿನ್ ಅದ. ದೇರ್ಫೋರ್ ಇದರ ಹೆಸರೇನು? ವಿನೈಲ್ ಅಯೋಡೈಡ್. ದೇರ್ಫೋರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ವಿನೈಲ್ ಅಯೋಡೈಡ್, ವಿನೈಲ್ ಫ್ಲೋರೈಡ್. ದ ಹೌ ನೇಮಿಂಗ್, ಹೌ ಯು ಆರ್ ನೇಮಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕಾಂಪೌಂಡ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಒನ್ ಪೊಸಿಷನ್. ದೇರ್ಫೋರ್ ಒನ್ ಫ್ಲೋರೋ ಈಥೀನ್. ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಒನ್ ಅಯೋಡೋ ಈಥೀನ್. ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಎನ್ಇ ಈಥೀನ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ನೇಮಿಂಗ್. ಒನ್ ಅಯೋಡೋ ಈಥೀನ್, ಒನ್ ಫ್ಲೋರೋ ಈಥೀನ್. ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನೇಮಿಂಗ್ ದ ಕಾಂಪೌಂಡ್ಸ್. ಈ ವಿನೈಲ್ ಅಕ್ಕ ನಾವೆಲ್ಲ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು. ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಡಬಲ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಹೆಲೋಜನ್ ಇರ್ತದೆ ಅವಕ್ಕೆಲ್ಲ ವಿನೈಲ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿಬೇಕು. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಗೋ ಫಾರ್ ಸಮ್ ಅದರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. This one very important, very easy also. Benzene ring attached to the carbon-carbon, again one bond. This carbon-carbon double bond followed by the carbon-carbon single bond attached to the halogen. They are called as benzyl. Therefore, they are called as benzylic chloride. They are called as benzyl chloride. How you are naming this one? They are very important. One. Yes, right. Therefore, one chloro benzyl. Or we are going for the one chloro toluene also. Toluene. This is what a toluene group. Okay. Next time, this is how you are naming this compound. This is iodobenzene. and also we are calling this as aryl iodide. We are naming this is what aryl all type of like this directly sp2 hybridization are attached to the carbon-carbon double bond attached to the halogen. They are called as aryl halides. That's right. Therefore, aryl iodide. And also called this is what iodobenzene. Iodobenzene. This is what just IUPAC naming. Well, iodobenzene or iodoarines will be carried. Therefore, this is what a simple naming of an organic compound. Well, if there will be we are using arthometapara, how we are using this arthometapara, that is also very important. You see here, this is what an organic compound. This organic compound attached here Cl and this is what CS3. How you are naming this compound, that is also very important. Well, numbering, this is 1 and this is 2. 1 chloro, 2 methyl benzene. 1 chloro 2 methyl benzene. And how you are naming this one? This is very important. Arthomethyl chlorobenzene. This is at artho position. Artho position. This is at artho position. This is called meta position. This is para position. Therefore, arthomethyl chlorobenzene. This is what the naming of an organic compound. If more than one or more than two substituents are present to the benzene. This is what I am naming the organic compound. There are so many. What is organic compound nomenclature? Just to be any organic nomenclature perfect. I can name lifelong. Whenever you organic chemistry and culture, all naming birthday birthday. Even separate, I have got color button. I must tell you that. Because in nomenclature, one separate video. Martin. Okay. Next one is after this nomenclature, we are going for the a nature of carbon halogen bond. Nature of carbon halogen bond. The nature of carbon halogen, not really. A carbon halogen bond nature hang each other. What is its proper? How it will be reactions? How this? Which compound react very faster? You see here. Simply I will tell you. This carbon attached to the halogen. They are called as alkyl halides as well as alkyl haloalkanes as well as haloarenes. And correct you know. This carbon. The carbon is always electropositive. Carbon is electropositive. These halogens are always electronegative. All halogens are electronegative atoms. Carbon is electropositive. Due to this charge separation, they are showing the polar. They are called as polar molecules. If they are polar molecule, means there will be charge separation and also there will be bond breaking as well as bond making also takes place. Due to this polar nature of a bond, this CH bond, therefore some chemical reactions are taking place. Either it may be breaking or making up a new bond. For this nature of this CH bond is very important. Yakanami alkyl halides, yak yukurna bag kalitundra, yukur reaction of bond, bacon in all lacto. Yak in all lacto on thundra, you were dokurna doing the bond, break up the bond, easy no bag, break a kachun by difficult. But yakandra, one electronegativity is an electropositive. Therefore, they are always repelling to each other. They are showing some dipole movement. Therefore, there are this nature of the carbon halogen bond is very important. And this whatever this carbon halogen bond, this carbon, you know, yaude alkyl halides, yaude on the chemicals with react avatandra, yak react akandra because of due to this charge separation. You know, the carbon halogen lagan tredena. If the positive ethi, you know, halogen negative. If the bagan in a teki bodu, barry negative atom hak bodu, barry yaude, one A plus, A negative. If yaude in the compound on negative or hak bodu, negative or teki bodu. If the yen and now remove madadu, matinon hak tevala. This property is torsed that these compounds are reactive. Why these halogens and haloarenes are reactive? Because of due to this polar nature of a bond. Therefore, these haloalkanes and haloarenes, they are very reactive towards the other compounds. Okay, from this one simplest, I'll tell you this nature of this CX bond. You see here, this bond, the bond length, the bond which is very strong bond forms, there are so halogens. X means not only X, here X means F, Cl, Br, and next iodine is there. There are these four halogens are in which carbon, in which halogen forms the strongest bond with carbon. Which halogen bonds very strongest bond, which is forms very weakest bond. That's we have to just analyzing with some mathematical data. Some data is there, some understood the values of the values not kissindra. Now decide on the go. Yaudu bahala easily react to the yaudu very difficult to react to the another. First one, type of bonds. Type of CX bonds. CX bonds. This is what a C, first F, CCl, next CBr, next is FClBri. In this next one, we have proven the nature of the bond, bond length. Bond length in the picometers. In the picometer. The bond length, how this bond length is varies, that's also very important. This bond length will use. You see here, this bond length is 178, mathematical, they are just mathematical data, 193, 214. You see here, this value is not necessary to remember. For you even backat or the nanopodena, you understand all the values thrown him and understand Mulakista Padagatin. Even values in C to the need of the Arkadangi. Okay? Next, this is what bond length. Next one, bond enthalpy. Bond enthalpy. That band enthalpy value is in terms of kilojoule per mole. Kilojoule per mole. That value is 452, 351, next one is 293, next one is 234. This nature of CX bond and bond length. You see here, this fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine. From the periodic table, the size of an atom increases from top to bottom. Top to bottom, hodang hodanga, e elemental size hachako toko. This is F, this is Cl, this is Br, next this is I. Next one, this fluorine atom attached to the carbon, and next this chlorine atom attached to the carbon, next this bromine also attached to the carbon, iodine also attached to the carbon. If size of an atom increases, means of course bond length will be. This bond length, this is yesterday 139 picometer. But that is 178. This is 139. 193. Next, this one is 214. Therefore, size of an atom increases, the bond length will be increases. Bond length will be increases. Next, next concept in here, carbon positive is negative. Positive, you will not negative. Halogens negative, this is carbon positive. One thing is, remember, if positive, negative, if for example, if these two choppies are there, they are very near, means there will be force of attraction is more. If you are there, you will be attractive power will be more. Therefore, if they are very close, means there will be very attractive force is more. If attractive force more, bond break, we will have energy. Therefore, this bond length, is always inversely proportional to bond enthalpy. Ee namu hang bond hang hechakko thokaitala hanga namu energy baal bekaagut idu energy kadime beku illi nodu idu bond length, therefore idu bond hechakko thontadandre energy enakutade kadime ko idu hechakko thontadandre ಆ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಎಂಥಾಲಪಿ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಏನಾಕೈತಿ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಆಕೈತಿ. ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ ಇದು ಬಾಂಡ್ ಸಣ್ಣದೈತಂದ್ರೆ ಎನರ್ಜಿ 452. ನೋಡ್ರಿ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ವೆರಿ ಲಾರ್ಜ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ರಿಕಾರ್ಡ್ ಇಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಲೆಸ್. ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ ನಮಗೆ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ಬಹಳ ದೊಡ್ಡದೈತಿ. ದೇ ಆರ್ ವೆರಿ ಅಪಾರ್ಟ್ ದೂರ ದೂರ ಬಹಳ ಅದಾವ. ಅವುಗಳನ್ನ ಕಟ್ ಮಾಡಕ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಕಟ್ ಮಾಡಕ್ ಬಹಳ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಕೊಟ್ರೆ ಸಾಕು ನಮಗೆ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಬೇಕು. ಬಟ್ ಎರಡು ನಿಯರ್ ಇದೆ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಬಹಳ ಕೊಡ್ಬೇಕು ನಾವು ಬೇ ದೂರ ದೂರ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಿಸ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಕನ್ಕ್ಲೂಡಿಂಗ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಿಸ್ ನೇಚರ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಿಎಕ್ಸ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಸಿ ಐಯೋಡಿನ್. ಸಿ ಐ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೋರ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟಿವ್ ದೆನ್ ಸಿ ಬಿ ಆರ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಸಿ ಸಿ ಎಲ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಟ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ಸಿ ಎಫ್. ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಫ್ಲೋರಿನ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಇಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಲೀಸ್ಟ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಕಂಪೇರ್ಡ್ ಟು ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಐಯೋಡಿನ್ ಬಾಂಡ್. ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ದೀಸ್ ಮ್ಯಾಥಮೆಟಿಕಲ್ ಡಾಟಾ. ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ ಡೋಂಟ್ ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಮಗ್ ದಟ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂಸ್. ಅವ್ರು ಭಯಪಡ ಹಾಕಕ್ ಹೋಗ್ಬೇಡ್ರಿ. ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಈ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ತಿಳಿಯಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಎನ್ಸಿಆರ್ಟಿ ಹೇಳ್ಕೊಟ್ರೆ ಅದನ್ನ ತಗೊಂಡ್ಕಿಸಿ ನಾ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಅನ್ನ ಈಸಿಲಿ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಮಾಡಿಸ್ತೀನಿ. ನೋಡ್ರಿ ಹೆಂಗ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ಹೆಚ್ಚಾಕೋತೈತಿ. ಬಾಂಡ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ಹೆಚ್ಚಾಕೋತೈತಂದ್ರೆ ನಮಗ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಎಂಥಾಲಪಿ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂಸ್ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಹಾಕೋತೈತಿ. ಈಗ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಈಗ ಬಹಳ ಸಣ್ಣದೈತೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಬಹಳ ಬೇಕು ಬ್ರೇಕ್ ಮಾಡಕ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಬ್ರೇಕ್ ಮಾಡಕ್. ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ ದ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ವರ್ಸ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಪೋರ್ಷನಲ್ ಟು ಬಾಂಡ್ ಎಂಥಾಲಪಿ. ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಎ ನೇಚರ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ಬಾಂಡ್. ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಥಿಯರಿ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಈ ಏನು ನಡೆದಿದೆ ಇದನ್ನ ಮೇಲೆ ಇಟ್ಕೊಂಡೆ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ನಾವು ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟಿ ಫಿಸಿಕಲ್ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟಿ ಪ್ರಿಪರೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನ್ ಹೆಲೋಜನ್ ಹೆಲೋಲ್ಕೆನ್ಸ್ ಹೆಲೋರಿನ್ಸ್ ಹೆಂಗ್ ಪ್ರಿಪರೇಷನ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅನ್ನೋದು ಇದನ್ನ ನಾವು ತಲೆ ಇಟ್ಕೊಂಡೆ ಮುಂದಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋಗಿ ಯಾವ್ದು ಬೇಗ ಪ್ರಿಪೇರ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಯಾವ್ದು ಬೇಗ ಪ್ರಿಪೇರ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅನ್ನೋದು. ಓಕೆ ಓಕೆ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಅನ್ನೋರ್ಸ್ ಗೋ ಫಾರ್ ದಿ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಪ್ರಿಪರೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನ್ ಹೆಲೋಲ್ಕೆನ್ಸ್ ಹೆಲೋರಿನ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಫಾರ್ ಸೀಯಿಂಗ್ ದೀಸ್ ವಿಡಿಯೋಸ್. ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಶೇರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಕ್ರೈಬ್ ಅವರ್ ಚಾನಲ್ಸ್.